to another video. Today here with our fourth and final installment of the Motorsport Marathon, working through all three of the games on the Xbox One generation of the Motorsport series, starting with Motorsport 5 and then moving on to Motorsport 6, and we had our first installment of Motorsport 7 last week. So if you do want to go and check out the previous episodes, they were uploaded at the same time the last 3 weeks. But yeah, here again on Motorsport 7, we split this one into two parts because of the number of vehicles we wanted to drive. To drive some of the cars that are either exclusive to the Motorsport series or some that are exclusive to this game, for example, this rather randomly added Honda Odyssey we're going to be driving. But yeah, working through the games, driving some of the cars that are unique to them. But yeah, this is what happened, our final installment here on Motorsport 7, trying to drive some of the unique cars from this game. Why is my car glowing? Slightly odd.
Yeah, I was just thinking that. Is it because you put white paint on it?
This is just the manufacturer. Yeah, I don't know why it's... Oh, it brakes well, actually.
You should not go on that fast.
That's true. It felt quite fast.
Oh no, he's pulling away. Making the gear change at 8,500.
Mine just about stretches to 5,000.
Oh no, I lost too much speed. Hang on, I forget. Is this front or rear wheel drive?
I'd imagine it was rear wheel drive.
I will find out.
Come mine on. Definitely was going by the amount of wheel spin from the back wheels.
Yeah, it's rare.
I'd be surprised if it wasn't.
Oh no! top speed.
I think 151 is my top speed. Almost.
I like your colour choice, sir. Go for this traditional blue alpine colour.
Is this or a sort of burgundy colour or blue without a black roof? Apparently all colour options.
Where's that terrible pastel yellow?
I don't know.
Can I do a weird green as well?
I think so.
Actually, I believe that car came in white. Do they have a white option?
No, they didn't. I don't think so.
You're trying to damage my perfectly computer-shaped wedge.
Yeah, I know, I seem to damage my... Wait, no, I've not got any damage. That was lucky. My light's slightly smashed in position.
So is mine. Can't think of any other Belgian game by Shelby.
Intercooled, turbo. Well, as a turbo and an intercooler, interesting.
Wow, that thing flies.
Quick actions. I'd never even
maybe
heard of
should.
The Dodge Omni before, which is the what it's based on.
Maybe we should have added rain. Come back here, you American eco-box. I need to beat you in my German eco-box.
I've never heard of this before. I'm slightly surprised Shelby would want to tune a small hatchback. But 5 gears. Yeah, okay, that's front wheel drive.
start lap two. Sedan is.
Wow, listen to that. I'm pretty sure these shouldn't sound like this.
Man, your van is fast. Said no one ever.
Yours is front wheel drive, isn't it?
Yeah, I think so.
This definitely is.
Every time I go to the corner, it's like you turn hard and you need to do a tire break.
Into the wall.
I think it's like big American engine, I think is the...
Yeah.
I seem to be getting any wheel spin today. Maybe I'm not turning hard enough. No! I stuffed it!
Wait, why is that not the finish?
It's not.
It's not usually on the winner though, is it?
Oh, crap. Keep forgetting that mine had to be the aid.
Oh, no. No,
but why?
Oh,
that didn't last very long. Spun it already.
A lot of whistly turbo noises. I've kept it in one piece at least. Reminds me of the sort of like Lotus, is it Lotus 311 or 211?
Oh, it's probably handles nice.
It does if you brake early enough.
I know there was a few engine options on this car. You're supposed to convert a Mazda MX-5 to its engine in this.
Okay. So there we go, that brings an end to our fourth and final installment of the Motorsport Marathon, which of course brings us to the end of this little series we've done. Quite a lot of fun to jump back onto the Motorsport games and do this. We did something similar on Horizon quite a while back, but yeah, interesting to see some of the exclusive cars that are on here. And even on Motorsport 7, I forgot some of the vehicles that are in here. I obviously play Horizon a lot more. But yeah, quite a lot of fun going back over the three Xbox One generation Motorsport games. Like I said, if you haven't seen the three previous installments, do go and check those out. They're uploaded same time previous 3 weeks to this one. But yeah, quite interesting finishing up with this Vul, which is actually a Mexican sports car. So could we potentially see this move to Horizon if it is indeed in Mexico? That could be quite an interesting thought. But anyway. That does bring an end to today's video and to the Motorsport Marathon series. So thank you very much for watching, and I will be back with the next video very soon.